Ah, Beether, look what you did. You got yourself killed again. Well, let's rewind time. See what happened. Alright, so we were making a whole new stream of Mud Babies. So let's see. Let's review. Last time we... You know, we made a giant, you know, ring around the ring of mud, generated a whole stream of tar babies, and wound up in the southeast corner. And that seemed to be okay. It makes the... It does seem to render the northeast mud babies a little bit irrelevant, though. But we did notice last time that if you start at the southeast corner, the southeast corner is like 13 moves away from Beether, and the southwest is 14 or something like that. It's not a symmetrical ring. So we, like, tried at the northwest corner, and that was just way too slow. So was northeast, but that does seem to fit with our general observations about how large the room is. So see what happens. Let's try a solution where we start from the southwest corner and go northeast that way. So what will happen is we're gonna have this giant U of mud babies closing in on us, of course. We're gonna go up here, we're gonna kill this brain, we're probably gonna have to retreat to the southeast. But my thinking is that because we're going southeast, we will not have to worry as much about the positioning of this mud baby. Right? Yeah, because it should, we'll wind up being, like, further east when this blows up, I think, and then we'll be able to retreat west and north somehow and wind up in here and be safe. And maybe these mud babies will harass us from an unexpected angle or something. So that's my theory. We will waste one turn doing this, but we beat the timer by several moves last time, so I'm not tremendously concerned about it anymore. There we go. That should be the right start. Now, we could do some minor variations of this, but right now I'm not too worried about my particular tar-cutting technique as long as it beats the timer. Yeah, so the point is that just that we need to kill the brain in time. This seems like, okay, well, that's not what I expected to happen at all. But we're on, again, we have a lot of moves to kill that brain with, so maybe we... let's see, so this lines up with diagonally, like we go just directly diagonally, we go over here. So maybe we don't actually cut that far over. Maybe we leave it like that, then. Maybe we don't get that last bit. I guess I might as well just kill those two mud babies. Not that I think that that matters a whole lot, but it could potentially help, I guess. You know, all things being equal, I guess I'll kill mud babies on the way, if they're convenient to do so. Okay, let's try this then. We still have an approaching wave front, but we can kind of get around it this time. Okay. So now, unfortunately, because of the way that the mud babies are in the center of the room, what's happening now is it's going to be really hard to skirt around them in the same way that we did with the other ones. And now we actually do have the problem of the flanking ones, where if we take too long smoothing this out, specifically it's right when that goes off, then they're just going to come make our life miserable. So we have to, I think we actually need to hurry up. Because what we need to do is we need to do this in such a way that it doesn't get, like, flattened out. Like our mud baby pastry, or mud baby dough, doesn't get too long horizontal. Because if this happens, then there's definitely no way around it. Then we're going to be rooted to the spot. Then we're going to have trouble killing all this. And then we're just going to be in danger. And there's no safe place in the northeast corner. We can't thin this out enough to go over here, I think. I'll try it. So what that would involve would be, like, going up here. And then we'd have to face west at an appropriate time and backswipe this. We'd have to somehow have this gigantic mass of mud babies all over here on the west side, and none of it on, like, this diagonal, or, like, not be able to overwhelm us here. Because the decoy potion, you'll notice, is in a spot where it does not provide any cover, and I have to use it facing southwest. So I can't, like, step on there and expect me to be able to shield myself with it. No, because it has to go over here. So I think the correct answer involves doing something with the horde, such that you go over here. And yet, I'm still, not really sure whether that involves, the southwest corner or the southeast corner. I guess I'll find out, but, I don't know yet. I guess I could do this. That's not as good as I want, though. So that happens, that's no good. I don't want that much stuff flanking me. If I can survive backswapping from this position, then I might actually prefer this to facing northwest, but I think for the time being, I'll go back to trying to face northwest then. I mean, maybe I just have to kill enough of these that I can actually just survive and make my stand. I mean, that's another option. But I'm still getting forced back because the oncoming horde is this thick. So that's definitely no good. That, you can't have that. So I thought maybe I could stand my ground a little bit better, but the movement order does not seem to support that. Which is understandable, because it's just, like, so thick that it's, like, six different rows, or seven columns, or something. But maybe if I do this, and I can turn around in time, so maybe don't quite go up that high. So don't quite go up that high, but survive this part, almost. So I'm thinking, like, if I draw the whole mass up here, then turn around and face northwest, and then maybe I've got, like, a few enough columns here that I can turn around, go north, face northwest, go south, come out the bottom here, and then go over there, and then over there. I think that might be it. We might actually be onto something here. So just don't go quite that far up. But still, like, thin the stuff out enough that you can survive. So, yeah, I think I tried similar things to this already, but we're not quite there. Because you need a few more moves. You need to be able to turn northeast and then get out in time. But I'm pretty sure, like, this is thin enough that if I, especially since this is the long end of the room, that if I could do that, then I would live. But we're getting there. We have a plan. We're just not. Reality is refusing to conform to my plan, as it often does. I'm not sure if I necessarily need to be killing a mud baby every turn, but it certainly makes me feel a little better. But I certainly don't like that this is happening. But yeah, the placement of the checkpoint certainly seems to suggest that you're supposed to kill the brain with a diagonal-facing orientation. I guess if he didn't want to give me that clue, instead what he would do is he would put a ring of checkpoints entirely around the brain, which would deprive me of this diagonal context or hint. Or maybe Reb is feeling rude and you're actually supposed to hit it on an orthogonal spot, such that you don't land on the checkpoint. I don't know. Any of those are plausible. I mean, I don't know the guy. But yeah, you can see that this is just, like, so horizontal that I don't like it. If it were more, like, vertical, if it were more, like, boxed up, like, up here, if, like, some of these were actually up here, then I would survive this part going down like this. And then I think we would all be fine. So that's why I'm trying to get so close to this door, but the fact that it opens is obviously a bit of an issue. So it's an extremely narrow balancing act. I don't know where the point of balance is, but the fact that I have to do that is a little bit annoying, though. So maybe instead you're supposed to do this. I mean, that was what I tried the other time, was this. And it almost works, except for the fact that it doesn't. Which could be said of a lot of things, but... then if I wiggle around a little bit more, then can I somehow prevent that from happening just by, using my freedom of motion in these directions? Maybe. Because maybe if I don't have to deal with this part here, then, like, we don't get that little tiny interaction here. But the problem is if I do that too early, then we wind up with this one trying to flank me. Yeah, so the problem occurs when I step here on that checkpoint. That causes this target to flank around and create that little two-wide gap. So if I can somehow get things set up so that that does not happen. I might even be able to spend a turn doing that to keep that from happening, because I'm pretty consistently killing the brain several moves before I actually need to. Like, I'm beating this timer hands down, so I could actually spend quite a bit of time cleaning up if I need to. Well, let's try it. There are specific mud babies, I should say, that are an issue. So, how about we pick a likely seeming spot, like about the midway point, and kill a few of them. That does not affect how I perform in the rest of the room, but it just kind of messes up the movement order a little bit, which is what I'm aiming for here. I still don't like that they're kind of trying to move diagonally to flank me, but I have a clean break here. At the very least, if nothing else, I did kill a few more mud babies, so I have fewer to deal with now. So whatever I was doing beforehand should be a little bit easier now. And I'm still definitely killing this mud baby with time to spare, so... like, I'm killing... yeah, so it could blow up now, so I could even spend, like... I could kill four more mud babies if I really wanted to. So, let's see where this takes us. Not anywhere good. That's because I've taken too indirect a path to that point. So, once I go north, and then, but not too far that I create too much of a blockade on my south, but also I need to go north enough so that I have, so that this doesn't happen, so I want some of them to go up that way, but yeah, there's still a lot to keep track of. There's also the fact that I killed the brain a little bit later, so less of the horde is up here, which is where I'd want it to be. If I could kill it faster by, like, killing, I don't know, some bit of mud over here or something, and then beeline to the brain, then the rest of the horde would be more up this way, and so it would be, like, more up in this corner when I'm done, when I make my brain run. Then more of it would be up here, and less of it would be down here. So that's worth thinking about. Maybe I don't kill any mud babies. I don't think I necessarily took that out as far as it could go, but it's worth thinking about. So I have a little bit of time to, I don't know, do something like this. I could probably do the rest of this still in time, but the fact that I'm ending my cut right here might be of service, maybe. The advantage of doing this in the corner is that I get an advantageous sword direction, and I think that kind of helps me duck around the horde a little bit, because as you can see, now I've got, like, a mud baby right there, and that's, gonna make things a little bit miserable for me. So that's, you know, that's what I'm trying to avoid here, of course. So the obvious way around that is to put this a little bit further down. So maybe two squares down, then? So maybe instead of doing this, I cut it up to, like, here or something. We'll just see how many turns of leeway I have on this. If I have some, I'll spend it killing mud babies instead of progressing. But otherwise, we'll just see where this takes us. So now we have a mud baby over here. Now that we don't have one east of the brain, I'll go ahead and try and make my run. That's kind of the other reason why I don't want to do this, is it makes it so that I'm on the same column as all these mud babies. And yeah, and I don't have quite as direct a path over to this as I want. But it seems like I'm mostly in time for that, so yeah. So just something to think about. I don't think this is really going anywhere, but it's still something I need to think about in the back corner of my mind. Keep that available. So the Royal Chamber, huh? Is that a hint, or is it just, like, an indication to where I'm at? Because I thought, like, there were a few other tunnels, like the Guard Tunnel. The Guard Tunnel did not have very many guards in it, as it turned out. So it was just, you know, another tunnel. Okay, does this thin out? Okay, so that still thins out the same way if I go over here. We're starting to get somewhere, but this is obviously concerning me. But, I think that means I just need to kill more mud babies. Remind me again what the... Alright, did I... Yeah, I stepped on checkpoint here. So what was my timing as far as killing that mud baby up there was? Pretty good. I could have killed 6 more mud babies. How about we do that? Let's back up to the point just before we kill this brain, I guess. And kill 6 mud babies. Alright, that's 6, I think. Alright, so we're still, like, killing this, we could have killed 2 more, in fact, actually, is what we could have done, because mud babies move before bombs explode from fuses. But, that has made our job a little bit easier. Maybe. But we have not really brought this horde up to, good size yet. I can't just directly go south yet, no, but it was worth a shot. I thought maybe I could just do that before those guys joined in, but no such luck. Okay, maybe not go that way. So it's a little bit unfortunate I have to spend a couple of turns here, like, kind of below the brain level when I would prefer to be above the brain level. As far as horizontal goes. I like it when movement order randomly creates a gap. Well, I don't say randomly, but pseudo-randomly, chaotically. Creates a gap, which lets me go southwest here. That's usually pretty good for getting in advance, so... You can see I'm as even closer than I've ever been to doing this. Like, a couple of more moves ahead, like, relatively speaking, and I can actually survive this kind of, situation. Like, actually... It still needs to be pretty specific, though. Like, I need, like, not just this mud baby, but also, like, a few... Like, probably, like, this whole group to be gone. If there's, like, some that are still west of this point, west of this column, that are up here, then that's okay, because it'll kind of fold in. So if I... That would allow me to kind of scrape diagonally, like, northeast. Scrape diagonally, go all the way over to this corner, then turn up, then turn and go all the way up here. So that would all be fine, but, The rest is still, yet to be determined. But you can see that I'm making progress. Like, these kinds of things do matter. So, I guess I'll kill 2 more mud babies. I don't think that's gonna single-handedly solve all my problems, but it could, I guess. And we probably want to do that at a different point on the map, so we probably want to do that... I think we want to do that before we go over here, so... So that way, when we do make, do go over here, we get the cleanest break possible. We don't have, like, a pileup over here. We still wind up with, mud babies that are southwest, though, because of the way I'm doing this. So this might be better, the fact that I only have this one mud baby to my southwest, because now I can immediately do this. That might be better. That might actually make a difference. So now I'm killing this with exactly the right timing. And we're still nowhere close on this because I, you know, did this maneuvering wrong. But, maybe somehow this makes a difference? So we want to go up here first, then east, and then like that, I guess. The other issue with doing this, though... The issue with doing that is I've spent time killing individual mud babies over here, but I've let the fuse burn out while I'm doing that. So that means that this door opens faster when I'm in the middle of, like... I get fewer moves in between killing this brain and going up and going over. So I've given up turns of doing that in order to kill single individual monsters. That's probably a bad deal overall. Like, you can see I'm very, very close to making this actually work, regardless of that. So maybe some small degree of doing that does help, but I think actually just having more turns to go up further and then over further and then back down before the door even opens over here might actually be more profitable in the end, because I can manipulate the entire blob that way, the entire swarm, the entire set of locusts here, instead of just killing a single locust and still having a giant pile of locusts, which I'm more constrained from running away from. Okay, so let's do the exact opposite then, I guess. Just try and do this thing more efficiently then and give myself the maximum number of turns possible. That's also probably not right, but it seems like the next logical next step, just for reference's sake. I could still kill... I could do that a little bit better, though. We can do, moves like this. Yeah, like this. Like, that's still as efficient as the next thing. And it still results in us killing Mud Davies incidentally. Because of the way we're doing the drag. So, we might as well do that, I guess. See, if we're too efficient about it, though, then that happens. That was not part of the plan. Also, I didn't do that right. I wanted to do that. Right. I'm supposed to do that. I'm supposed to have this little protrusion here in the southwest. That's what I meant to do. I took a few extra moves. I didn't quite stab that as fast as possible, but I'm still way ahead on time. I can kill that brain, so I guess I will. This is stable as long as I don't mess with it, so I guess I'll go up first. Then I have to fix that, of course. Or do I? Maybe I can just go straight down. Why was I turning? I think this is actually it, because now, there we go. That's the ticket. This is what I was visualizing all along. And it's beautiful. Beautiful. Just look at that. So there might actually be more, if you do that, like what I did there, I never turned, I never tried to back up and fix that little mistake there. I just kept my sword northwest and going all the way to the corner and then down. So I think if you do that, I think there's actually more leeway than I thought. I think there might actually be a lot of different ways you can do that then. So, okay. I am reasonably satisfied. I will go ahead and leave this room with pride. Oh, hi there. I know exactly where you are. Yeah, you're right there. Okay. The brain is the world is a really nice place. Like, that's where I keep all my stuff. That's where they keep all the brain food, you know? Okay, so are we doing a boss fight? I think we're doing a boss fight. Well, I mean, I don't know. It's got like 20 whole attack. I'm not sure how I can And see, a goblin is 6 times as dangerous. It's got 120 attack. Oh, it's a super goblin. That's right. This is a brained roach and a brain goblin. So that's like a 40 attack monster and a 240 attack beast. Let's not let that happen. That's right. How am I gonna get in there? This might be kind of hard to deal. Actually, it'd be impossible to deal with if it were a tar. So that would be the final line of defense. But your goblin spilled the red paint all over your wonderful chromatic goo. So excuse my incompetence while I disassemble this. Well, I'm afraid I'm trapped. I can't actually exit the room until I kill you. So it's gonna be me or you, buddy. And I think if I have to choose who dies, I think it's gonna be you. Yeah, that's true. There's still like 100 of them or so. Yeah, how are we gonna do that? You got an idea, Beethro? I don't. Cause like, I could kill them manually, but it would take forever. Can I just have like a mimic to kill them instead? Oh. Okay. Slaves? What slaves? Did I miss something? Alright. Okay, that is the underground civilization conquered. So, thoughts, feelings. There's a lot of efficiency in this hold, honestly. That's probably the main theme. I'm surprised that, like, fighting arenas didn't really come back, but I guess that's what you could have called that last, mudroom I just did. Yeah, we'll go ahead and do that. Oh, hey, Estengard. Yes, this was definitely the first time he saved the world from a mad brain, and also the first time he saved the world from a whole bunch of slayers. But this did come out after Journey to Rooted Hold, but I think before The City Beneath, which is why I'm humming so hard at all this. But yeah, this was fun. You know, a lot of rooms got on my nerves a bit, I have to be perfectly honest with that, but, you know, it's definitely a good change of pace. Like, this is definitely a lot of, I don't play a lot of rooms that are like this, and it's good exercise. You gotta really sharpen those tactical muscles. Wait, maybe I'm mixing my metaphors again. In order to really just get the work done. Okay, so this is more or less what I expected from a level like the Royal Chamber. But, so where does this go then? Alright, so. Entrance 2. Okay. Oh, so we're back here then. Okay, so then this is only 4. So, alright. So, what does this leave us with? We solved the secret room, but there are no guards in the guard tunnel. But we solved the one in the regular tunnel, which we could warp even further back if we wanted to do by this room. But I don't think, Okay, so that leaves us with a choice. We can either do the guard room in the secret, mastery tunnel, or, we could do that other timer room that was, kind of, like, secret, held away in the other, restore screen. Help me. Save me for myself. So you can do this room, which isn't right here. We'll figure out something to do with this. Or we can solve this room, which seems to be on the same path, which I have to do sooner or later. So that kind of, like, makes it part of the required sequence of secrets to go to the actual area. I guess because, was there a master wall in this hold? I think there was. Yeah, I think it's right here. So that would take us in here, where presumably we'd go up here and then do, hold mastery stuff. I must have missed the part where there were slaves. I mean, today's the 17th, so it's been a little while since the last recording session, but I forget where they mentioned that earlier in the hold. I might have to just go back through the cutscenes a bit and mention where slaves were mentioned, because I thought these were just citizens. Maybe I missed something important, but that's alright. I'm prepared to accept that. Anyway, right. So what I was actually saying was, let me go over to this hold. My logic here, again, is that solving this room does not open up any extra rooms for us, at least until we get to this part. Whereas if I solve this room, then I can step on the checkpoint here and, you know, go back and whatnot. And I can see what the next room is. So I'm more excited about solving whatever this room is to see what the next hold is than solving this one, which does not give us any extra rewards. So I'll probably just solve this when I eventually get to the end of this tunnel and can't go anywhere else, and then I'll solve this. Or if I get horribly stuck on one of these rooms, then I have that room available left to me. I don't think there's any other secrets that I missed. I got all of them in this these levels, except I missed one here. I'm not going to worry too much about this, but if I absolutely run out of things to do, then I'll go secret hunting in this level. But I have a slight suspicious feeling that I might actually be returning to this from another level. In fact, this might actually be the level that you come back to at the end of this tunnel. That's just a guess, though. But it's a guess that may save me a lot of time in the future. Okay, so let us go back to... that'll do. That is a fine spot to leave off on. So everything is solved. We'll go back to the deeper tunnel. And we will get out of here. Boy, it sure is a lot easier to go through all these rooms when there's no monsters in them. And I'll go ahead and step on that checkpoint, too. Sure. Alright, time to start on the Master Tunnel, I guess. Might as well. Don't have anything better to do. I mean, I could give up on mastering the hold if I feel like it's too much work, but I don't see any reason to do that yet. Right, last time I didn't get very far in this room, because, guards can move over potions. That's, not working to my advantage this time around. And if I take the invisibility potion too early, I can potentially survive this part, but, eventually there's gonna be guards way up here that I just can't do anything about, unless I use decoy potions to drag them down. Which may actually be the correct answer, now that I think about it. Okay, well, let's try and survive while invisible, I guess. There's still, like, a lot of these, though. Like, normally in guard arenas, you have a lot of space to work with, but they're just kind of on you immediately with this, this thing here. I want to drag, like, at least a few of them down. I'll wait one more turn. Okay, that ought to do. They're still kind of spaced a little bit awkwardly, but I think I can maybe work with this. Let's be a little bit greedy then. Okay, so this is perfectly safe then. Well, not perfectly safe, but we can start all the way over here and just really slowly kill these guards at my convenience. And I have a lot of decoy potions, so maybe I can make this work. I'm not 100% sure I can make this work, but I'll give it a try. I'm not about to give myself a challenge to not use all the decoy potions, so if I can find a solution which does use all of them, I will gladly take it. Alright, sweet. Just do this nice and slow. It's like Evil Eye rooms. Just don't wake up too many of them at once. Just take it nice and easy. You know, when you get your murder on, you just gotta do it one by one. You know, there's no such thing as a fair fight when Beethor's involved. You know, if you're in a fair fight, you're done something wrong with your setup. You want to create fights which you're always going to win. Oops. That guy had a better of me, but fortunately I have time powers, so I will win all one-on-one sword fights. Even if winning involves running away. Or I could get, you know, a little cocky and take 3-on-1. Oops. I don't know why I keep insisting on bumping into their swords, but that's just my first instinct, I guess. Alright, so phase 1 complete. Phase 2 involves dragging some further down into the room, like so. And then they get into invisibility range, and then I can draw them in. So I think like this, I don't think I'm going to run out of decoy potions. I think I'm going to be able to solve the room like this. It's not going to be particularly efficient or... like, resource-wise efficient, but I will get the room done this way, I'm pretty sure. I'm gonna run into fewer issues than I did the other time. I'm just gonna back up and do that a little bit differently. Yeah, there we go. Give him the old loop-de-loo. Okay. So next up, we still want to drag down as many of these as we can. Probably want to just make sure I get those ones. I still have 5 left, which should hopefully be enough. So I need to start working on these guys. That wasn't very good, so instead I'll just try and get all of these. Okay, that... I did not expect that at all. Okay. What if I put it this way? That's not good. Okay, what if I put it directly in line with that guy so he takes a little bit longer to kill him? Okay, that'll do. Well, it's not great, but it'll do. I got the, that last rank down a bit, at least. So I can do that. I'll get all of them down. I'm pretty sure 3 should be enough for those 5 guys that are stuck at the top. It'll just have to work. At least I think it will. Okay, not the biggest fan of how that turned out, but... good enough, I hope. I just want to make sure that that guy gets down, I think. Alright, is that enough? Did I leave that last guy in range? Yes, I did. Alright, so that's the slow and safe way of doing this room. There's probably a faster way based upon using the decoys to build yourself a little, barricade, and then you do it, not invisible. In fact, let's take a look at the demos. I'm getting a little curious. Let's give some other people a little bit of credit in this, Chaco LP of, oh, I'm not connected to CaravelNet. Hold on, I guess I'll be right back. Okay, here we are. Alright, yeah, let's, well, there's Mixvelati up there. Let's download a normal person's demo. How do you do this, Dragonfogel? You wait a while, okay, that makes sense. Okay, yeah, that's as far down as I let them go. So then we kill them nice and slowly like I did before. And we, just drag a few more of them out at a time. Okay. Then we do it like that. Okay. Basically an iteration of what I did in the LP. Which makes sense given that I did this in 457 moves and he did that in 370. So, you know, that's quite a bit, but it's not a huge improvement. The next tier would appear to be like around the 260 move mark, so disoriented, how do you do it? Alright, you make them go all the way down here, but you still get invisible at this spot. And then you do the same thing, but you put down the decoys while you're busy fighting the other ones. Again, makes sense. I want to see a cool demo where they go invisible a little bit later. Like, can you survive that, is I guess what I'm curious about. That's really the only reason why I'm doing it this way. Alright, Rev's brother, show me how, I believe that's correct. Show us how it's done. That far. Okay. Well, if second place still only does it this far, then I'm prepared to accept that that's correct. And then you just, do the rest real fast, and then, use the decoys to help you out, and, that's it. Oh, and you use the last 2 to clean those up. Okay, that's interesting. Well, that certainly saves time. Alright, you know what, since we conquered the hold already, I guess I'll leave CaravelNet on and I'll upload my scores while I play. Okay. So, I'm looking forward to playing the exact same room but with no decoy potions. What have we got? It is not the exact same room. Okay. Well, this looks like something he experimented with while doing the serpent rooms in the other level. Okay, well, that's all well and good. I'm still gonna get trapped at some point, though, right? Yeah, that's gonna happen. But this one is gonna let me out. And then the rest basically take care of themselves, so I don't need any decoy potions at all. Is that what I'm seeing here? None of these are trapped. None of these are, like... I know sometimes rattlesnakes can coil up in a self-coiling problem where the tail is on the inside of the coil and the rest is all impenetrable. So I still have to watch out for that, but... The rest is all cleanup, isn't it? I don't think I need any decoy potions, am I? I guess now I will be a cool individual and not use any of the decoy potions. Never mind that it's easier this way, and we've already got a wall of flesh in the way. That's no good. You don't want any walls of flesh. At least not when they're not working for me. Oops. I am not as careful as I used to be, apparently. Which is understandable, given that I'm trying to finish rooms fast rather than with as few deaths as possible. Because there's no incentive to avoid death in Deadly Rooms of Death. If you die, you just undo. Or you restart the room, or go back to a checkpoint in the extreme case. But if you actually give Beether the old dying animation, okay, that's no good. We can't have that happen. Because this isn't going to go anywhere, and this isn't going to go anywhere, and together we have aforementioned wall of flesh, so we could fix that with a decoy potion, but we're not gonna go that route. So when did that happen? That happened quite a while ago. Okay, let's back that truck up. Back up the base, as it were. Okay, there we go. That'll get that fixed. He'll eventually uncoil himself. I think, as far as I can tell, the west side of the room seems to be behaving itself. That looks all fine. So I think I can ignore that for the time being. Just focus on getting all the rest cleaned up here. That's not an issue because this is accessible, and so is this. Alright, you go over there. Okay. That'll make things a little bit easier. You, the longest, also need to be eliminated because you are a mobile wall that I cannot seem to control properly. Yeah, so again, we're not going to be doing this the maximally efficient way. The maximally efficient way is going to involve using the decoys to make my job easier. But we're going to do this the very slow and, careful way. Which might not actually be good LP material, but whatever. That's, if you get me, you're getting the room solved any which way that gets the job done. You're not necessarily going to get anything immediately flashy, because all my flashy stuff takes time to set up. I do all my magic tricks in advance. But, I don't know, occasionally I look cool, I guess. I mean, I guess this would be the right time for philosophizing. I actually had something else lined up for that, but we're kind of near the end of an episode already, so I kind of feel a little bit silly doing that now. Well, whatever. Anyway, actually, this kind of brings up another point that the people in chat were discussing the other day, which was that Beether is already well aware of rattlesnakes, I believe. When he first encounters them in Journey to Rood Hold level 16, I think I don't remember the exact dialogue, but I think it's implied that he's already familiar with them, that he's seen them before. Adders 2, I believe, which is understandable. I think, like, they do exist both on the surface and in dungeons. It's just that, you know, for whatever reason, in all the Architect's Edition era holds, they just never showed up. Okay, that's not going to make anything worse. We'll just kill this one. It's going to take it nice and easy. Well, maybe not quite that easy. That's an aesthetic eyesore. I don't want that to happen. You know, B-Throw is not a time... You know, I might not be, optimizing, but I'm not gonna walk around the long way just because of being careless, especially if I have time powers that I can abuse to get, faster real-time results. You know, this isn't a blind race or anything, but it's certainly an opportunity to understand just what makes us tick, I guess. Right, so, I guess all Neophyte Smite Masters are probably decently familiar with it. I mean, what we've seen in clearing school, rattlesnakes seem to be on the curriculum. I certainly wouldn't expect, let's back that up a bit, I guess. I wouldn't expect, like, the in-game tutorial is unfortunately, like, hilariously brief. I would not expect that to be representative of what actual, like, I guess, in-universe clearing school would actually be. Especially since, it's, like, stated to take several years. I wouldn't necessarily expect Smite Mastery 101, the Smite Master selection, to be canonical in that particular regard either, but it might be closer to the truth. But in any case, I think it's fair to say that, alright, and this is why I backed up, because I just want to do this. Kill all these. One square per turn. You can certainly do better with decoys, but we can kill all these reasonably well off now. Yeah, so it's something that, it shows up. It's just, for whatever coincidence, because they just weren't implemented in the engine yet, they just didn't show up in holds that were built for a while. Or maybe they were, like, wild beasts that they were familiar with from, like, walking around on the surface, but they just weren't seen underground or something. I don't know. Excuse me. Okay. So this is, someplace where you're not expected to remain behind. I guess this is one way to make sure that you get out in the open as fast as possible. So we won't be doing this room today, but I guess this is what to expect from tomorrow. Or, not tomorrow, next episode, which might or might not be tomorrow. Yeah. Okay, well, this is not what I was expecting from the start from the guard room, especially since the guard room has nice flooring and tiles, where we're back to the plain old checkerboard. There's a nice aesthetic attraction to the checkerboard, but, yeah, we're getting a whole bunch of very optional rooms that I guess were maybe meant to be part of the main sequence, but maybe they're a little bit harder than usual, maybe they're a bit less thematic than usual, I don't know. But for whatever reason, they're here and not anywhere else, and they are optional.